Good morning, welcome for our second, third lesson. It's a pleasure to introduce to you Fabio Massimo Bertolo. Fabio Massimo Bertolo is, in my opinion, the greatest combination between philology and auction, because Fabio Massimo Bertolo studied with Pasquale Stoppelli, who has been a great philologist in Roma La Sapienza, University of Roma La Sapienza, and then he devoted to books in general and manuscripts, and now he is the CEO of Minerva Auctions. Probably we can see later what is Minerva Auctions. I think that you may be really interested in all that is related with ancient books. Yesterday we went to library just to see directly also very precious books. We saw, I told Massimo Bertolo, yesterday we saw Orlando Furioso, third edition. And also for him, it is a great, astonishing vision. But now we are waiting for a great lesson devoted to the Summa by Luca Pacioli. This is one of the most important first printed book all over the world, we can say. And this is the reason why when Fabio Massimo Bertolo sold it in Minerva Auctions this year, it has been a great event, not only for philologists, but for all those who study ancient books. So this is the best introduction to our study of the life of text, from manuscript to printed books. So I give you a good lesson, and thank you to Massimo Bertolo to be here from Roma, and have a nice lesson. Thank you.
Thanks to all, thanks to Paola for the invitation, and welcome to this lesson. I can't say any more than Paola said, because I have a degree in Italian literature, as Paola said. I studied Italian philology, and then I had a PhD in Italian philology, studying history of the books, printed books, and I spent 1 year in Cambridge many years ago, studying the process to produce to book production in the ancient time, so I mean in the 15th and 16th century. After this experience, I've taught for 10 years in University of Cassino, but then I started to work in 1996 with the Christie's is one of the major auction house in the world, together with Sotheby's, and I started in the book department for the reason that I was able to describe an old book, to make a collation, to do a lot of works on this. And then with experience, I became also an expert in commercial terms, so I can do evaluation, etc. It's interesting that you have been yesterday to the Bologna library. It's not the university library, non archiginnasio, because this is a different point of view. You have seen some important, really important books in public institution, but the same, most of the same of these books are also is able also for few people, few happy people, but not so few, to be in private hands. This is my job, to give important books to private collector. And so today I will explain something about the history of the printing, a really small suggestions, I would say. And then I talk about this really important book. This was in the last June, the Italian best prize ever for a printed books in an auction, and one of the most in the world. So it was sold for a large amount. But anyway, if you have also a small pocket, you can buy interesting books for a few, really for a few, and then I show you. So let's start. This is some suggestions. It's not a sort of a traditional academic lesson. A book is always a book. This is what I mean. This is the book that I'm reading on the train. It's called Michael Stetter, La persuasione e la retorica. Michael Stetter was a young scholar, died 23 years, so an important intellectual of the 20th century, the beginning of 20th century. And this is a small edition by Adelphi that you can recognize. It's a sort of homage with to Paola, but it was absolutely the case because I've taken another one. The other two are this book. This is one is Discorsi di... No, this one is Aldo Pio Manuzio. It's printed in 1549. This one, 1541. Well, it's in my hands. It's not yours. It's a friend of mine. I got some books in the office that sometimes I use also for this reason. But I will tell you, it's a real book. It's a real book printed in 1449. It's just so no, it's not a fake. It's not a fake. It's a book similar to that one. I can give you in your hands because. The destiny of the book is to be managed, no? It's to be read, to be managed. This is my opinion, this is my idea, and this is the idea of, I would say, all the people that loves book. Books have been to be, has to be managed every time. So this book is printed in 1449. I show you the frontispiece, that one, that includes all the information that we have in the modern one. So the author, the title, and who printed the books? Aldo Pio Manuzio. The title is Grammaticarum Libri Quattuor. And then we have this large image. It's absolutely the same of this small logo. This is the logo for a book printed in 16th century. But the function of this image is absolutely the same. To recognize who printed this book, where was in Venice, there was a flagship outside the shop of this man that was, if I remember, Bindoni. The name of this printer was Bindoni. This is the marca tipografica. It's a logo. It's the same of logo. This is the name. And you can find in Venice, in the area of the printer books, the flagship of Mr. Bindoni. So if I want to buy the Aldo Manuzio Institutionem, I go there and buy there, or anyway, I buy in the fair and the books and book in the library that I can find around Italy in 16th century. This is the same for the other one, that is a frontispiece more ordinato, I would say. Due discorsi, Faustino, Summo, Padovano. It's a sort of explication that there is no reason to choose this one or another book. But anyway, it's different the format. We have the small one. It's called Ottavo. It is quite close to our small Adelphi. No? You can see the difference is about 2 centimeters, no more. And the original of this format coming from Venice. It comes from a printer that's called Aldo Manuzio, Aldus Manutius, as they pronounce in England everywhere. Aldus Manutius, ovvero Aldo Manuzio, was the person that introduced not the format, but introduced the idea to put in this small format the literature, the important literature, classical literature, Italian literature, vernacular literature, and everything. So we can say that the introduction of this small portatile, tascabile format was made by Aldus Manutius. And this is not mine, but of the auction house, it's about the 120,000 euros, the income for the auction house. If you buy a house, it's the same. It's much easier, no? You go there, you ask to an agente immobiliare, and you pay. And you pay from both sides, so from the buyer, from the... there is a... No, no, so.
Grazie. Grazie.